everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Panduh. I want to give a huge shout out to everybody in the LGBT community. Happy Pride Month, y'all. Don't get it twisted, they celebrate every month. I checked out this website called iglta.org and they got something going on every month, y'all. All over the world, even the US. So go ahead and check out that website. I'll put the link below so you guys see what I'm talking about. I am going to go over some of the events in June so you guys can get the opportunity. And events in June are going on in the US. So those who still want to party up and celebrate with everybody, y'all, I'll let y'all know where to go. And then before I get to that, I kind of want to discuss something that my friend had brought up to me. It was related to the LGBT flags. There's tons of LGBT flags in different categories. However, there was one flag he felt like that related to me, and I'll explain why that I want to bring this up in this video today. So stay tuned, everyone. Very close friend of mine, he's like a brother to me. You know, we talk almost every day. No, we talk every day. And, you know, he, you know, doesn't really like to identify himself. He doesn't like no titles. He's not a millennial, but he don't like no titles. But, you know, he has, you know, in our friendship, we first, in the beginning of our friendship, we never talked about sexuality. We never talked. That never came up. We were just really two of my best friends in college, working pretty much in the same area, and we just bonded on everything else, and we just never talked about it. So, you know, 3 years went by, and he finally started to open up to me about how he felt when it came to the office sex and the same sex. I love my friend. I mean, you know, I didn't care, but it's like, well, it doesn't change how I feel about you. You're still my friend, I'm gonna write it down for you, that's it. So, you know, I'm kind of going on this journey with him, and he brings up to me about, you know, the different flags that are in the LGBT community, but he also brings up that there's a flag for people who support the LGBT community, which is called the Straight Alliance flag. And as you guys can see on my right here, it's like an A or upside down B, however y'all want to describe it, that's supposed to represent for activism or ally. For those, clearly that means, you know, those who support this community, if you wanted to join the activism and making this more acceptable in our society. You know, showing the people that anything but is love. Stop trying to put your own one category on it. Love is love at the end of the day. So, I really, really, and then before I get into it, before I forget, the black and white is supposed to represent the heterosexuality. So, you know, that's obvious. So I was like, okay, this is cool, you know, I need to rock a flag. Like, you know what I'm saying? If I'm going to go to a parade or a festival with him, I can do that now. And I didn't feel like, you know, I felt in place. I know, you know, at the end of the day, the LGBT community is about diversity and inclusion, so nobody was ever going to judge me for being there, and you know, vice versa. However, I just felt so out of place, and so when my friend told me about this flag, it may seem so minuscule to y'all, but it was a big deal to me. So with him telling me about this flag, I was like, you know what, I'm going to rock this flag, which I want to go to this event. I want to take a more active course, a more active interest in what matters to you, because I care about you as a friend. And go to these events and rock the flag with you. Like, you know, I could rock the Jamaican flag, I could rock any other flag, but this flag, you know, just shows that, you know, I don't have to think one way to support a person. You don't have, you know, to be a lawyer to defend someone's rights. So, you don't have to be a lawyer to defend someone's rights. So, at the end of the day, like, I just felt this overwhelming amount of love, passion, and I just wanted to just share it with everyone. And I'm gonna, I think either my friend, me and my friend are probably going to do the NYC one, or Miami Pass, we can't do that one. But we're gonna do a Pride Parade or festival together, and it's gonna be tons and tons of fun. If you gotta go to one, let me know. We'll see if we can hop to that city too, and we're gonna have fun, y'all. Like, we're all gonna have fun. So nonetheless, let me get into these dates. Like I told y'all, like the cities and everything that's going down. You guys can check out the website yourself, but if you just want a quick overview of the upcoming ones. We have some coming up on the 15th and the 16th, which is between Ohio, Memphis, Baltimore. 17th up to the 23rd, we got Chicago, Toronto, San Francisco. And then 23rd to the 30th, we got like Nashville, Houston. NYC June 24th, all right now, from Bronx.
It be popping in New York. I know for a fact it be popping. Minneapolis for 24th and Seattle for another 24th as well. So, like I said, y'all, go ahead, check out the website, find out the next place you guys can go to. Any comments, any views you want to express, I'm all down for debate, it's too much debate. Go ahead in the comments, I'll respond back to some of those. And don't forget to like.